Drought, Migration and Civil War in Darfur, a presentation based on the ECC Factbook. The civil war in Darfur, Western Sudan, is one of the deadliest in the world. Since 2003, fighting between rebels and the government, and between different rebel factions, as well as violence between ethnic communities, has caused several hundred thousand fatalities and displaced more than 2.5 million people from their villages. Originally, the war evolved out of rebel groups' struggles against the economic and political marginalization of Darfur by the central government in Khartoum. Yet, it became rapidly intermingled with local conflicts over resources, whose origins can partly be traced back to the Sahelian droughts of the 1970s and 1980s. Whether these droughts were caused by anthropogenic climate change, or instead resulted from natural climate variability, is still a matter of scientific debate. Claims about a direct link should therefore be considered with caution, even if they come from very respectable sources such as the current Secretary General of the United Nations, Ban Ki-moon. Irrespective of this scientific debate about climate change versus climate variability, the Darfur case is, however, illustrative of how conflicts may develop when societies are unable to adapt to the consequences of climatic changes with peaceful means. And these lessons matter, as there is strong evidence and scientific agreement that climate change will generally bring about more intense and more frequent droughts, despite the uncertainty about the causes of any single event, such as the 1980s drought in the Sahel. Based on the ECC Factbook, the present analysis redraws the linkages between climatic changes in the Sahel and the crisis in Darfur. It also presents different efforts to resolve the crisis in Darfur and highlights the main challenges for the future. Rainfall in Darfur has constantly been declining in the 1960s, 1970s and the first half of the 1980s, culminating with the Sahelian drought and famine of 1984 and 1985. Nomadic pastoralists living in the northern part of the region were hit particularly hard, whereas populations in the southern part of Darfur were somewhat less severely affected. During the 1980s and the 1990s, a high number of northern pastoralists thus relocated further south into areas mainly inhabited by settled farmer communities. At that time, the southern part of Darfur was already experiencing mounting pressures on local resources due to natural population growth and an influx of migrants from neighbouring Chad. In combination with increased migration from northern Darfur and the gradual abandonment of traditional fallow systems, these factors led to a vicious cycle of overexploited soils, deforestation, and further depleted resources. The situation was such that an increasing number of Darfurians grew discontent with the central government in Khartoum, which did little to avert famine and quell disputes between migrants and residents. To the contrary, its ham-fisted counter-insurgency tactics often revolved around what Sudan expert Alex Deval has described as Khartoum's penchant for addressing local conflicts by distributing arms to one side to suppress the other. In addition, mounting resource scarcities and increased migration brought ethnically distinct populations together and under circumstances that made conflict likely. The Sudanese government, which, at that time, already faced an insurgency in southern Sudan, exploited this situation and exacerbated local land disputes to impede the formation of a strong rebel movement in Darfur. These dynamics were set in a particularly fragile context. The Hakura system, traditionally responsible for sharing resources between farmers and herders, had come under stress, both because of the reduced availability of land and because of efforts of the central government to nationalize communal land in Darfur. As a result, local conflict mitigation institutions had lost much of their functionality. Farmer-herder relations were further strained by the endorsement of a racist discourse affirming the superiority of Arab groups, including many of the northern pastoralist communities, over African groups, making up a major part of the southern communities. These and other factors made the region highly susceptible to conflict over diminishing resources, which could in turn be exploited by the conflict protagonists. Several attempts at conflict resolution have been made. Since 2003, the international community's main efforts concentrate on peace talks between the government of Sudan and different rebel groups in Darfur, mediated among others by Chad, Qatar, the African Union, and the United Nations. From 2004 on, these have been supported by a multilateral military intervention led by the African Union, which has passed under the command of the United Nations in 2008, as well as by one of the largest humanitarian operations in the world. To a lesser extent, development projects aim at reducing local vulnerability to drought and land degradation. For instance, the European Union and the United Nations Environmental Programme, UNEP, are working on the development of major water catchment projects. UNEP also works with Tufts University on enhancing pastoralist livelihoods in the Eastern Sahel. Overall, violence in Darfur has decreased since 2005, and humanitarian access to the civilian population has been improved. However, major obstacles remain on the way to a lasting peace. Mediated peace talks have failed, as have two peace agreements. Two multilateral military interventions by the AU and the UN have proven ineffective. Additionally, the Libyan crisis of 2011 has facilitated the flow of weapons to Darfur. The humanitarian operation Darfur has been successful in reducing the rate of acute malnutrition as well as crude mortality rates. But widespread insecurity, as well as bureaucratic and political obstacles, make the work of NGOs difficult. The government of Sudan has been willing to embrace international initiatives in the domain of environmental protection in order to reduce Darfur's vulnerability to climate change. However, limited capacity and weak coordination mechanisms between the federal and regional level, as well as with civil society actors, have undermined implementation. Resolving the crisis in Darfur hinges on successfully addressing these multiple challenges. This analysis, as well as all graphs and data shown, are available at factbook.ecc-platform.org. The ECC Factbook is an online tool designed to inform both policymakers and the general public about conflicts with an environmental dimension. It provides case studies, infographics, analysis, and data on over 100 environmental conflicts worldwide.